Hello and welcome to another episode of GDL-IL, GDL Israel. Today we're going to have quite a fun time with showing the power of both UpScript and Compute Engine. And in order to show the flexibility and the ability to run interesting test cases on both platforms, I decided just to take this fun subject of Monte Carlo simulation and see how we could utilize those two different products in order to test it and see if we could get some interesting results to real problems that we have under our hands. So without further ado, let me just share my screen and we'll jump together into the code. I find it very useful in most of the cases, just to talk less and see code. So let's move this one so we won't have any problems. And we'll open this little doc. I'll try to, I guess the fonts are quite large, but if we have problems, just feel free to ping me on the Hangout and we'll be able to increase the font size. Actually, I could do it right now. So what we're having here, basically what we want to test is to show the power of UpScript. And we took the fun world of Monte Carlo simulations because when we have problems that are happening in the real world, usually there are quite a lot of outcomes that could come for each and every scenario. And what we're doing in those simulations, basically we're trying to identify the different variables that we have under our hands, and then run it many times with some kind of random distribution that allow us, in the end of the tests, to come up with numbers that harness us with the ability to fine-tune and to get an answer. And in our little case, we just choose the option to help a good friend of mine, who is a real rock star salesperson, and we'll try to find what are the things that are constraint him and how we could help him. How we'll do it? Well, we'll use first UpScript just to show the power of Google Sheets and UpScript and how you could do things quickly and share them with others. And then we'll take it for the real world and we'll show together how we could run it, the same code basically, the same JavaScript code on Node.js inside Compute Engine, which is very efficient way to do it. What is our problem? Well, basically we have this brilliant salesperson and they could get big deals that pay, let's say, X amount of dollars or smaller deals that pay Y amount of dollars. And of course, the level of effort for a bigger deal is much higher than a smaller deal. So let's take the scenario of the end of the quarter and our salesperson got 30 days to make the most out of her time. What she could do? She should choose just to close big deals or just smaller deals, or what is the perfect blend? And this is basically what we'll try to do here. I'll share all those links at the end of the show, so feel free. A much better explanation than the one that I gave, you can find on Wikipedia. Then if you want to check out what it's all about with Node.js and how cool it is to run your JavaScript code inside it very efficiently, of course. And Node.js, but you need some machine to do it. So Compute Engine is here to help, and we'll touch quickly on how you could set your own Compute Engine. Since we did it last episode of GDLIL, I won't touch on all the basic boilerplate steps that you need to do in order to have your own virtual machines, but I'll just take it a step further. After you have the machine, you install the Node.js, now what you could do with it. And of course, UpScript, there's just a link to all the details and documentation that you could enjoy there. So let's go to our case. And first, let's define the problem. So in our world, let me just open it so it will be a bit wider. And we'll try to squeeze everything to the page so you'll be able to see it nicely. Let's take it like this. That's much better. The chart here is just to give us a sense of how the data look like, so don't focus too much on it. Basically, what we have here is a test case. Let's remove all the data that we have right now and look at it together. So if you noticed, I have this new sheet that I created, and for this GDL show, I just created a new menu that will allow us to choose several things. And let's try with the most basic way to just run simulations that basically you could see are just filling now the details and the chart is updating in real time. And what we have here is a very naive approach. We're just coming with X amount of big deals and Y amount of small deals. In our case, it's the same amount, 25. And we have this percentage of a number of percentage that we set in advance that say something like in 30% of the deals that she will approach that are big deals, she will be able to close them successfully. And let's say on smaller deals, it's much easier because of lots of different reasons, and the percentage there is 50%. So you could see here on 10 cases, more or less, those are the numbers. And we could have a slight feel for the numbers here, what is the max, mean, standard deviation, and the median. And a nice aspect here will be probably to take the conditional formatting. I'm going to the cells that I want to apply this condition formatting. And the conditional formatting will say something like, okay, everything that is above $250,000, I just want to make bold. And in our case, the median is 265, so let's correct it. We'll go here, conditional formatting. And I could see now quite quickly where more or less I'm getting the best results. But this is, of course, not mimicking reality because we won't be able to do the same things, right? Because probably a bigger deal is taking more efforts from us. So we'll go to the next phase of running more control deals. And what will happen here, you'll see, is we enforce the assumption that a bigger deal is taking actually twice the time of a smaller deal. So now the script is done. You could see that I got this nice dialog box that telling me what was the max amount that we were able to achieve. And I just confirm it. And here you could see quite clearly that if we were able to do one big deal, then from the 50 deals that we could achieve if we would focus just on smaller deal, now we could have only 48. And then it's going down. And here it's much interesting aspect because we know that in the real world, it will be much closer to this, right? We'll spend more time on the bigger deals. And here the case when the median is around 180,000 and the average is 200. Let's see all the cells that are above the average quite quickly. Conditional formatting and above, let's say, just 200,000. And you could see nicely that it's more concentrated at the beginning of everything. Now let's take it for the next step to show what the code is doing. And here you could see this, let me make it, code that actually running everything. So basically we just took the assumption of how easy or how hard it will be to close a big deal. And in our case it was 20% and then 50% for a smaller deal. The amount of executions that we could allow ourselves to do on smaller deals and bigger deals. And this is the returns on each deal. And of course, you could play with those parameters, and those are the parameters that will drive all the simulation. Later, what we're doing is just running this scenario, and we're running the scenario basically on all the amount of big deals because this is what's driving us or constraining us from making all the smaller ones. So what we will do, we'll call this function of running blending, and this is that function. And we're passing the right line, so we'll be able to update our sheet quite easily. And this is just boilerplate for all the parameters that we want, all the variables that we want to keep. And now we're calling the loop of the big deals, and we're calling this simple function that's returning the randomization, or basically the answer if we were successful with approaching the deal and closing it or not. And what this function does, basically, it's very simple. We just taking the random function, it will be a number between 0 and 1, and we're trying to see if it was 20% and the number that we got is lower, we were able to win the deal, and if not, it's just false. And of course, the same with the smaller deal. So it's very, very simple. And when we're coming here and we want to test if we won the deal, we're just going on the deals and it will start with one deal and then increase it. And if we were successful and it's true, we're just adding one to the deals that we were able, and we're adding the money that this big deal will put into our account. And of course, the same will be done with the smaller deal. So the same simple code. In the smaller deal, however, the magic is here. We have two constraints here. One is the simple constraint of smaller deal should be always lower than the max amount of small deals that we could do. But then we want to enforce the ability of, hey, a bigger deal is twice as hard, that's why it's two here, than a smaller deal. And the combination of two can't exceed the max amount of deals that we could allow ourselves to small and big. After we do that, very easily, we're just updating the lines with all this different data, and those are these lines, basically here. And very nicely, we could get some nice aspect of what's going on here. So you saw that with the current parameters, and let's have a look at them again, of 20% and 50%, and those are the returns, it might be worth to just focus maybe on this range of deals. So to focus on, let's say, something between 6 to 12, more or less. But if we're changing the odds just a little bit, let's say that we are more successful with a bigger deal and it's 0.4, and we're coming again here, let's remove all the data, so we'll start clean, and we're going again here and running it. We'll get the results quite quickly. But as you can see here, we're waiting a bit. And that's basically one of the things that I wanted to note. If you need to run simulations, and especially for the real world, UpScript might not be the tool for you. Here we're playing with it, and it's a nice way to have a feel for some aspects of the data. But wait with me, bear with me, there's 2-3 minutes, and you'll see how you could do it for real with utilizing Compute Engine. So here we got some different results, and you could see here that the median is higher, 270. And if we'll go here, use the conditional formatting, and we'll drive here, basically it should be 270. You see that it's tending a bit more to here, but it's not very clear what's going on. And of course, if we'll play this scenario again and again multiple times, we'll be able to identify if it's driving more to this side and aspect of the data, or more to the lower number of deals. Now, of course, here you could play and run it multiple times, and we could definitely do that again if we want. One thing to note here is that you have a full ability to use, of course, the message box, but also the logger itself. So you have the ability to go to view, click on logs, and getting the output here, very useful when you want to debug things. But one of the even nicer thing is just the ability to put a breakpoint on each function and each line that you wish, and then select the right function that we want to run. In our case, it's run scenario blending. Click on the debug, and you'll see in a minute that I'm opening the debugger, I'm getting a full view of all the variables, I have the this object that containing all the variables that I have here, and now on this line, basically I could see and go above or get into and step in into the functions. Let's close it, we don't need it anymore. We have here the results back. Let me just refresh it so it will be much quicker, and we'll get the results in a second. And as you can see now, it's maybe a bit clearer that we want or wish to aim to this range of the aspect. Now, all this is quite cool, but the ability to run it for real is basically coming very handy when we taking Compute Engine into our hands. So I took the code from UpScript. Basically, you could see it here. Few changes into it. First and foremost, since we are going to run in Node.js, we could utilize some models. NPM is your source, and there are so many that it's quite funny to look sometimes for the best ones. In our case, since we're working with a lot of data now, we get to get out of the logger, or in our Node.js world, console log. We want to work with files, and here I just choose the ability to work with files, with text files, and basically built CSV files that later on I could upload and analyze in Google Sheets again. So in our case, we'll try to run, let's say, 1,000 times. We could do actually 10,000 times. It will be very, very efficient and fast, and you'll see it in a minute. In terms of percentage and all the aspects that we touch about, very similar to what we saw, 20% chance to close a big deal, 50% for a smaller one, and those are the limitations that we put to ourselves, and these are the returns. Now we're just putting some boilerplate code to run it, to run our blending scenario X amount of times, and each time we'll get the maximum, and we'll want to output everything to a CSV file. By the way, this is all I need in order to export it to a CSV file. I'm using outdata as a string object, and I'm just making sure that I'm putting commas and end of line in the end of everything. And as you can see here, very straightforward and easy. Now, when we'll come here to our compute engine, let me make it live. We could run this little nice application, and for 10,000 runs, we got the results back after 451 milliseconds, so roughly half a second. And you could see here that we were able to achieve the best results with a higher number of big deals. So probably the best recommendation that we could make in this case with these assumptions, these are the ones, is that we want to focus on more bigger deals than smaller deals. Now, you might notice that it's not black and white, and it's not that we have one thing. And I guess it's very similar to the real world, where usually the answers are quite gray. You need to find the golden path, and in most of the cases, it's not very clear where they will be. And I guess that one of the most important aspects to note is that your assumptions will drive the simulation. So it's very useful to have those type of simulations when you feel that you have some control or some assumptions that are close to reality. And in our case, we could definitely say something like our brilliant sales gal could close bigger deal 30% of the times. Why? Because for every 10 deals that you approach, 3 are done deals. And with those assumptions in hand, we could definitely go and see how she and he could utilize their time the best way. So this was just fun little things about how to utilize Node.js, UpScript, and run some Monte Carlo simulations. I hope in the near future to show some cool things that you could do in App Engine as well. And all the code, of course, will be on my GitHub repository, and I'll put a full transcript of all this show in the footnotes, so you'll be able to track it. And until next time, be strong and have fun. Bye-bye.